Hey YouTube, it's Tyler the Antenna Man. Today I'm going to talk about why indoor TV antennas do not work that well. I get people all the time commenting saying, hey, why don't you review more indoor TV antennas? There's a reason why I haven't been doing reviews on many indoor TV antennas. The main reason is that many indoor antennas just aren't built well. They don't have many elements to pick up VHF or UHF channels that well. The other reason is that TV signals do not travel well through building materials. So it doesn't matter if you have the world's greatest antenna. If it's sitting in your living room, the TV signals aren't gonna travel through all of that aluminum siding, insulation, and wood to get to that antenna. My YouTube channel was created to help people cut the cord and get as many reliable TV channels as possible with an antenna. And most people aren't gonna get that with an indoor antenna, so that's why I haven't been reviewing many of them. Because it would be wrong of me to say, hey, buy this indoor antenna, and the good chance is most people aren't gonna get reliable reception because of the building material in their house blocking the signals. I'm going to demonstrate to you right now the effect of building material on TV signals. I set my tuner to WVRE, which is one of the weaker TV stations in my area, and tried to pull it in inside even with a good RCA directional antenna. And I was not able to get anything more than a jumble mess of pixels. As soon as I moved the antenna outside, I was able to lock WBRE in, which is the NBC affiliate in my area. So if you had lived in my scenario, you wouldn't be able to pull the station in indoors. I did the same thing with a low-powered PBS station in my area. No matter where I moved it, even in the right direction, I was not able to get anything inside. But as soon as I put the antenna outside, it came in right away. So now you can see why I try not to recommend indoor antennas for people. Although I do get comments almost every day with people asking me what the best indoor antenna is. And to that, I recommend the ClearStream 2 Max because it works really well as an indoor antenna and a small directional outdoor antenna. So you can use it inside to kind of see if you can lock in all of your TV stations. But if you have problems, you can easily just mount it outside. It even comes with a mounting pole. I include the link in the description of this video to that antenna. For those of you that have a local homeowners association that doesn't allow outdoor antennas, there is a federal law that prohibits the restriction of outdoor antennas, even from local homeowners associations. I'll have a video on this topic in the coming weeks, but in the meantime, I include a link in the description if you want to learn a little bit more about it. Subscribe to my channel for more cord cutting related information. Have an awesome day.